Well, I grew up coming to Bandimere Speedway since I was in footy pajamas. Family sport, grew up around it. My dad would build a race car from the ground up himself. You know, my mom did all the maintenance on the cylinder head, so it really was a family affair. They were gone a lot and on the road, and I got to see how much hard work there was into really doing that, you know, semi-professionally. And I think that was kind of happened at a really pivotal moment for me to make that decision that this is what I wanted to do. And I remember being up here at the Mile High Nationals and watching the rigs come in with the paint jobs and the corporate sponsorship on them. The light went on and I said, these people get paid to do this for a living. At that point, everything kind of started, you know, clicking for me, where I thought, okay, that's what I want to do. I had no idea how you got to do that for a living, but that's what I wanted to do. I came up through the ranks, super comp, competition eliminator, alcohol dragster, alcohol funny car, and was lucky enough to drive for the Darien and Meadows top alcohol dragster and their A-fuel dragster. That's what led to the opportunity to race Top Fuel. Later that year, Don Schumacher came and asked me to drive a car for him to fill in for Tony moving over to the U.S. Army dragster, and they needed to finish off the year with Excites. I've won in two of the NHRA's professional classes. It's probably more important to me that I'm one of 14 drivers overall to have done that in the whole history of the sport, male or female. To have been able to drive Top Fuel dragsters and funny cars, I mean, it's a pretty steep learning curve making the transition between the two cars. The cars react quite a bit differently. The funny car, because you are sitting behind the engine with the body over the top of you, it becomes more an issue of trying to see where you're going down the track and fighting a car that doesn't really go where you want to go. The dragsters are the bigger adrenaline rush because you're sitting a few inches off the ground. You get a much better sense of the speed. But for me, probably the adrenaline rush in the dragster is just a little bit better.
And Melanie Troxel has her first career win.
My first win was Pomona 2006. To get that first win, I mean, I think a lot of that has to do with not thinking about the fact that it's a final. If you're thinking about that stuff, there's too much going on in your mind. A little extra nerves and you're excited about all of it. So I try and just make every run the same as every other one, as much as you can. You know, you can't block all of that out there. But to get a win in Pomona and then not long after that in Las Vegas, I think that same year I was nominated for two ESPYs and got to go to the ESPY Awards. And at the time, I was trying to downplay all of it in my mind. And I don't think I was able to really appreciate these things at the time.
You know, I'm incredibly honored to be in the company of such an incredible group of women here. And to be representing drag racing on top of that is pretty incredible, I think, to see drag racing kind of embraced by mainstream sports. And just to see us get a little bit of recognition out there. I'm very honored.
But I got to look back, I think, after the season was done and realize what a special year that was. One of the great things about our sport is that we have made a point of finding ways to get the kids involved, especially girls, because I think once you're a little bit older, it can be intimidating to come out and race against the guys. But if you get them young enough, they haven't bought into all the stereotypes. We have a lot of women and girls in the sportsman ranks. That kind of feeds the health of the sport in general, definitely the female racers out there. You know, drag racing has ways that you can come out and just on a Wednesday night bring your car up and test it out and get your feet wet and see if it's something that you might like to pursue. And I think that's probably one of the best things about our sport. You know, at a time when the media makes such a big deal about women in other motorsports that aren't winning races, that aren't having the success that we're having over here, within our sport, it's not a big deal. And I think that just goes to show how long we've been doing that, having women not just compete, but win races, and at times dominate the sport. I think it's great that we're kind of put that out there and show other people how diverse our sport is. I think that really sets us apart from other forms of motorsports.